This is Planet Crunch. Including biodiversity, forests, farming, fishing, shopping, tourism, the media, population, nature and us, money, waste and plastic, energy, water, climate change, conservation, and food. Out there in the blackness of space, there is just one blue, green, and brown speck. Unlike dead Mars and the Moon, it is uniquely alive, vital to us and to millions of other organisms. And that's changing. No one expresses planet crunch better than Sir David Attenborough.
A buddleia bush, and on it, peacock butterflies, red admirals, tortoise shells. Is there anything that's more colourful, more beautiful, and more widely enjoyed in our gardens and the countryside than those butterflies?
Biodiversity is just one of some 16 aspects we'll interconnect in this summary of where planet Earth is heading and where on board. We move up the plant and animal kingdoms, from fishes to amphibians to reptiles and the birds. With that breakthrough, the feather, for the ability to reach every corner of the planet, high and low. Then came the mammals, some cleverer than others. And it seems we are not that clever when it comes to sharing the planet with our natural neighbours, indeed relatives. Rather than limiting our use of natural resources as our numbers increase and with it global consumption, and we often destroy the very life we ultimately depend on. That's planet crunch. Big tools, small brain, some would say. It seems we can be our own worst enemies. The soil is potentially full of life, but if we mismanage it with chemicals, cut it to the bone, in the end it will be us who are the real losers. Another way to damage our rich heritage is to overgraze it. Livestock, be they sheep or cattle, reared for our food on cleared forests, can turn fertile landscapes into deserts. It's true underwater too. Marine life can be exceedingly prolific if it's given the chance. From scallops on the seafloor to huge basking sharks sieving tiny plankton at the surface, the whole food web of the oceans is a treasure trove that should not be pillaged for short-term gain. The problem is the gain. Millions of our extra mouths to feed. Thus, overfishing. A bluefin tuna, a Porsche of the sea, is heading for a can. And so are lots and lots of shoppers. GDP, gross national product, is being considered a misleading basis of achievement for national, read natural, because that's a better measure of human success into the future. They say money makes the world go round, and if you build it, they will come to Dubai, famous for its extravagant lifestyles, ski slopes, fancy food, luxury shopping, and doubtful authorities, all here in the desert. Money is Dubai's lifeblood, but so death threatened when COVID-19 arrived via its aviation hub. People left this tall, ephemeral city in the sand. So is Dubai doomed? Will archaeologists of the future ask about a ghost city like Machu Picchu and Stonehenge? Or can tourism save it? A jumbo jet. Money is vital to ecotourism, especially in Africa, where staff have lost their jobs and having to resort to poaching the other jumbos they were trying to protect. In fact, all kinds of tourism have been hit by the pandemic. Grounded planes, no cruise ships, few visitors, and with plenty of social distancing. And it's sparrows that have checked into the hotel, where the foyer is full of the farmer's hay. The other guests are goats, and there's plenty of room for more. But it's not all bad news. Oddly, some good can come from COVID-19. This is how it was before, at Zante in Greece. Not much room for sea turtles to nest. As ever, more and more humans, less and less nature. Yet another planet crunch. At last, room for loggerhead turtles. 1,500 nests were counted by dedicated volunteers. To Galapagos. In the past, eco-tourists have been able to visit some of the most remote and extraordinary places on the planet, sometimes in the most comfortable and expensive conditions that money can buy. But it's a free breakfast for a little heron. That's if he can get it. Now, what's so funny about sewing? The petrel's breakfast is plankton. Those tiny creatures, the crucial link in the food web that includes iguanas, cormorants, fur seals, crabs, and much more. And that's what the tourists have come to see. Then there are the famous ancient giant tortoises, plus passenger. And neighbours. And there are boobies, blue-footed ones. On tourists' t-shirts too. A swallow-tailed gull, fished at night, helped by its big eyes. Now it's lunchtime. A lovely bit of squid for the chick. It will soon be time for another fishing trip out there in the abundant seas of the Galapagos, where there's a party going on board. Moving on from Galapagos to other forms of tourism and adventure. More and more people want involving activities, often to help the planet, which is a great idea. Eye to beady eye with the massive bearded vulture, one of Europe's most spectacular and talented birds of prey, also called the bone breaker. You can see it in action in part two of three parts in the longer versions. Because of misleading reports about attacking livestock, pairs of bearded vultures were put together in captivity in the Alps in an attempt to repopulate the mountains of Europe. It worked. The dark, big chicks were shown to the press, the public, and kids were fascinated. Then it was a case of moving the two chicks up to a place where they could be looked after and gradually released into the wilds of the Alps. This story turned out to be a surprise, as you can see in part two of three in the longer films. There is no question the media has publicized the plight of the planet and its nature. After all, we are nature. Nature is us. Without it, we have no chance. The elephant on the planet, not in the room, is the number of us and our consumption. It will take a major effort and drastic action to turn things round. But it can be done. But it may take a star animal, like a gorilla, to make a real impact and change. Question: where does a large silverback sit? Answer: anywhere he wants. The media may have been kind to gorillas, despite the King Kong image. But it has been very unkind to sharks. Indeed, some television channels endlessly reinforce the Jaws reputation. We are the so-called deadly killer assassins. That's us. Fins are eaten in China, throwing away the body, still alive, of this ancient, vital, key link in the ocean food chain. There are a lot of Chinese, and now a lot less sharks. The total human population is some 8 billion and counting. In Africa, the late Wangari Maathai hit planet crunch on the head.
We humans, as a species, we need the other species much more than they need us. And if other species disappeared, we would definitely not survive on this planet. But if we disappeared, there are many species which would probably say, thank God.
Along with Sir David Attenborough, a modern-day version is a young girl from Sweden, appearing here on a mural in Bristol, England. Greta Thunberg, who watches and challenges politicians and corporations to take action now, so the next generation will inherit a better planet. That includes what we do to it, what we consume more and more, especially food, often from many air miles away, like bananas, a fruit bat, possibly a link to COVID-19, to China, and a pangolin, another innocent victim of our fatal interference. Perhaps it's their revenge. The nature of planet crunch hits back. It seems we will eat anything. We have an obsession with food, with our surfeit of TV programs when many people around the world are starving. Cattle on cleared forest land, and sheep, pigs have changed landscapes. Horse, deer, venison. Bison, red Indian food. Kangaroos on the barbie. Beer paws. Seals from the sea. Fish plus dolphin attached. This is more controversial, but in Norway, you can go whale watching by day and eat part of one that evening with a certificate to prove it. This lion won't waste much. We do. Our lifestyles sometimes seem to depend on what we throw away. It's even the trolley that it came in. Aluminium. And of course the dreaded plastic, built to last. But that's the problem for a coot on the River Thames in London, or on a beach 5,000 miles away in Kenya, home to a curious crab. In fact, that plastic could have been dumped in the Thames and carried across the oceans, along with so much more of our rubbish, everywhere, from sea floor to mountain top. At least paper is a natural product, recyclable, and also makes useful nest material for the white stork, an adaptable bird which features in the accompanying book, Planet Crunch. So, of course, does energy and the crucial changes in our use of it. From fossil fuels to green renewables, this is the biggest shift of all, the planet crunch. Every plant, every butterfly, every person is connected, and now we all face the greatest challenge. climate change, even the climate crisis or climate emergency. Too much carbon dioxide up there and other gases. Snow. Everything's affected. A wagtail, ice, and a dead dabchick below, suffocated. Then come the floods. The drought. Affecting people and their animals worldwide. Glaciers melt and the sea level rises. And houses crumble. Water may be great for ducks, and some other wildlife may benefit from what we have done with it all over the world. We need fresh water for irrigation, drinking, and many other uses. But these dams may prevent fish migrating and flood out endangered species like the very rare Iberian lynx in Spain. You can see what happened to a village also in the longer version of the films in part 3. The nature of planet crunch is now of great concern, but action speaks a lot louder than words. Take that very shy antelope in Kenya, the mountain bongo. Difficult to see, difficult to protect, but here's how, one way. Ender Beebe's school has the answer.
But the teacher in charge, yes, with the pupils, go out of the classroom.
We conserve the animals.
Ah, when they like to see me.
I fed Motahi. I'm in the front line because I'm proud to be a Kenyan. Thank you.
It's a team effort, young and old, black and white. But can they save the mountain bongo? If they can protect its home, the forest, and if the children of the future can cope with the crunch, planet Earth can thrive. It can be done.
What a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands much more. And I never knew, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
There's a lively, free Planet Crunch book to go with the film series. For details, visit brockinitiative.org.
What a wonderful world.